They wouldn't tell me who it was. So I flew out from Myrtle Beach. I flew all the way to L.A. Folks, by the time I got there, my arms were so tired. Every time, but it doesn't work well. I got this. They told me who I was going to sing with. I was going to sing with Celine Dion. They told me that, and I about peed my pants. But we got to do this song. It was really cool, man. Because she just she was such a sweetheart, and we got to know each other. When you're on doing these shows like this, you're standing beside each other and you do like multiple takes. And while they're setting up the cameras for the next time, you know, there's like 15 minutes in between takes. And we're just sitting there. And at first, I didn't know what to do. I thought she might be nice. She might be mean. Who knows? I was just trying to be cool. So I was just kind of like, what up, Celine? And she has that French-Canadian accent, you know? She looked over at me, she goes, what's this up, Ryan? We got to talking, man, and it was a game-changer for me because I was telling her how difficult it was to do the production show that I was in and do the same show every night. It was just wearing on me, and I just felt like I wasn't in the right place. And she gave me some advice that I'll never forget. She looked me right in the eyes. She said, Ryan, do what you want to do. Do whatever makes you happy. That was important, man, because less than a year after that, I made some major changes in my life that affected my path to this day. So I'll tell you more about that in a bit, but right now I'd like to recreate that song with Ms. Darcy Park, the song that Celine and I sang on American Idol. We hope you enjoy it.